believe adventure is what defines us as skiers. The minute you give up on exploring is the minute it's time to hang up your skis and take up knitting. This quote from Matt Harvey, editor of Free Skiing Magazine, really does embody the sole principle of skiing, the need and love for adventure. But to me, skiing is not just an adventure, it's an art. The mountain becomes a canvas, your skis become the paintbrush, and the picture you paint, and the picture you paint becomes the representation of what you feel on the inside. For years, man has looked to the mountains as a way to express himself and to get away from the stresses of real life. Up there, stress, obligation, time seem to fade away, and your senses get overwhelmed with the ecstasy of knowing that you're only one turn away from a brand new adventure. Up there, possibilities are only limited to how bad your thighs burn and how hungry you are for that beer, bacon burger waiting for you at the launch. Through a passion-fueled innovation, the technology surrounding the ski industry has progressed over time, giving skiers the tools to conquer the terrain that was once thought impossible. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the world of skiing. As you can see right here, this guy's conquering. The first set of innovations was the invention of camber, edges, and side cut. Camber, as defined by the Castle Ski Catalog, is the implementation of an upper curvature in the body of a ski, as you can see here. What this does is it effectively puts the center part of the ski higher than the tip of the tail. So this is important for a few reasons. First, before this happened, skis were flat. So when you stood in the center of a ski, it caused the tips and the tails to rise. So when you were trying to turn, there was no effective hold on the tip of the tail. So basically what happens is like you spin up. Kind of like the same feeling as when you're walking down the stairs and you miss that last step, stomach drops. That's what would happen when you were skiing. After the addition of camber, it effectively distributed the weight throughout the whole length of the ski. This allowed you to have an effective edge hold during your turn and allowed you to not have that spin-out effect that I mentioned before. The second innovation was the invention of an edge. As defined by Michael Long, a ski industry professional and ski shop manager, the edge is a length of metal that surrounds the base of a ski, as you can see here. Before edges, skis were made of wood. So when you're trying to ski through the snow and make a turn, it would kind of slide out. This was a problem because it was very ineffective, and when skiers were racing, they had to make gates. So if you're trying to turn and like hit a gate, your ski would flat out from underneath you and you'd lose valuable feet to make that gain. With the invention of edges, the metal was effectively cut through the snow, allowing you to keep that edge hold and effectively make the gains. The last innovation was the invention of traditional side cut. As defined by Skiing Magazine's article, The Art of Carving, it is the width of the ski taken at the tip, the center, and the tail of the ski. Traditional side cut is described as the width, here being the widest, underfoot being the narrowest, and then at the tail again being the widest. This is important for a few reasons. Before this, skis were perfectly straight. So when you were trying to turn your ski, they didn't really want to make arcing turns. They just kind of wanted to stay in straight lines. By effectively putting varying widths of the ski developed a turn radius. This also helped in aiding you turn the ski. Before, you would have to kind of hop and pivot in order to turn your ski, which if you're going at fast speeds, is kind of dangerous because you can catch a downhill edge and fall pretty hard. By implementing the different widths throughout the body of the ski, you're effectively able to turn by just moving your weight laterally. Kind of like if you're riding a bicycle, when you're riding fast, you don't want to stay up straight and turn your handlebars, right? You kind of lean into it. Same concept with the ski. The next set of innovations happened kind of with the next generation of skier. By the 90s, people were tired of skiing on the groomed runs of resorts. They wanted to explore the mountain, the backcountry, and the side country, and they also wanted to ski powder. For those of you who don't know what powder is when you step outside after a few feet of fresh snow, and you step and your foot just sinks, kind of like you're stepping into water. These innovations were the invention of reverse camber and reverse side cut. The problems with traditional side cut, traditional camber skis for skiing in powder was that powder is a lot less dense than traditional snow, which is kind of like hardpack. The narrow underfoot of a ski makes it really difficult to stay afloat. Luckily, Shane McConkey identified that skiing on powder is kind of like skiing on water, as you can see here. Looks pretty similar. So he invented reverse camber. Reverse camber is, as defined by Powder Magazine's buyer's guide, the center part of the ski, instead of being higher, is lower, so it's kind of like a banana shape. This keeps the tips and the tails up high, as opposed to traditional camber, which points the tips and tails down, making a submarine effect. This allows you to stay on top of the snow and float on top, kind of like you're surfing or water skiing. The next was reverse side cut. Because traditional side cut was the narrowest underfoot, you would sink a lot. By making it wider in the middle and wider up top and narrowest at the tail, you effectively had enough float to stay on top of the water. And because the tail was the narrowest, you could smear turns kind of like a surf style. In conclusion, the ski industry has progressed over the years with the demands of the industry. I know that skiing has sparked an interest in my life that can only be fueled by exploring and adventuring. I can only hope that after this, you guys have a spark in your life and take to the mountains in search of your own adventure.
Please stop.